the notion of the company came about by not really thinking about it too much. I really tried just to think about the next step, and becoming interested in algae was the first step. Seeing if I could grow algae in coffee cups is where we started, was the next step. Then you sort of build a company around that and end up eventually in a situation where you have a plethora of opportunities in front of you. You have all the uses for algae that we found. I wouldn't say that I had a plan at the beginning. If I did, it would have been shorter. We grow algae at Pond Technologies, and well, it turns out that algae is a pretty interesting organism. It's mostly the stuff that people want to get out of their swimming pool when they get an infection, but actually it grows very, very quickly. It'll grow faster than pretty much anything else. In sort of theoretical limits, you go from a tablespoon to 1,000 tons in like 10 days.
One of the unique characteristics of algae is that they can capture and utilize carbon dioxide, not only from the air, but from industrial emissions. And they can grow very fast when you give them the right amount of carbon dioxide.
If you want to grow a ton of algae, you need about 2 tons of carbon dioxide to make that happen. It's a lot of carbon dioxide. So if you and I decided we'd like to start an algae business, the first thing we need to do is go find ourselves a lot of carbon dioxide. It's not that easy to come by in just the environment. I know we're concerned about carbon levels in the environment, but there just isn't enough in air to do that. Luckily, industry concentrates it for us in the form of a smokestack, and we take the carbon dioxide that comes out of that, we introduce it into our bioreactor, the algae consume the carbon dioxide, we deliver the right amount of light, the right amount of micronutrients, we control the rates of harvest, all the aspects that make the algae sort of like superstar Olympic athletes, and we are able to achieve a continuous growth and harvest system. So we continuously feed in carbon dioxide, the algae continuously consume it, and we continuously harvest algae out the other side. Pond is currently using carbon dioxide from smokestacks at a couple of different locations. We've done a lot of work at St. Mary's Cement at their kiln in St. Mary's, Ontario, where we take the untreated emissions and we grow spirulina, a kind of algae that's terrific for a sustainable protein, so it could be very easily incorporated into something like the next Beyond Meat burger, with the exception that it's a perfect protein, even better than what's in the current product. We're also taking a cleaner source of carbon dioxide from Markham District Energy, just down the road from us here, where we will be growing nutraceutical grade algae, compounds like astaxanthin and phycocyanin, which are antioxidants and colorants and very important. As well, at Stelco is going to be the largest facility that we've contemplated thus far. We'll be growing something on the order of 2,000 tons of algae, likely destined for aquaculture and animal feeds, but also for biofoams and some food colorants as well.
Every smokestack is an opportunity for Pond. When we first started working at St. Mary's, we'd drive to the stack and see the emission source and say, oh, you know, the stack is running, we're polluting the environment. And when they would do stoppages, now we've kind of changed our philosophy in saying, hey, the stack is running, we're growing algae. As opposed to, hey, the stack's running, you're polluting the environment. It's more now seen as, hey, the stack is running, we have an opportunity now to grow algae off that emission, which kind of is different way to look at a stack.
After about a decade into working with heavy industry and understanding some of their problems around emissions, I would say that most of them are working very hard to do what they can to reduce their emissions, and they're taking a solution like ours very seriously. They see it as a very important step towards their sustainability goals.
Algae is the future of the food chain. We will face days that the population is too high, that agriculture cannot provide enough food for human nature. So algae is the highest source of protein, carbohydrate, lipids, and it would be the future of our generation.
We haven't reached the limitation of the algae, and every day it kind of surprises me of what it can do, what environments we're finding it in, or what environments we can expose it to. They're pretty rugged, they're pretty durable. They've been around before us, and they're going to be around after us. And it's an amazing little creature, I guess you want to call it.
We're either going to control algae or it's going to control us. I mean, people are becoming aware of the enormous algae blooms that we're getting. People are scratching their heads, how did that happen? It happened because algae exposed to slightly elevated levels of carbon dioxide with the right mix of micronutrients will grow incredibly quickly. And we say, well, that's great. It's utilizing carbon all by itself, except it's choking out all the rest of the life. So we are in danger of becoming an algae planet if we don't check our behavior. And the best way to check our behavior is to take this incredible voracious appetite that algae has for the pollution that we're making and turn it to our purposes.